Yep. And we back. Hey guys, Tuesday morning, day off, up and about today, have a massive day ahead, got going to do some gym, got a massage, a little bit of recovery, then we've got a podcast, and I'm also heading into F45 in the city to get some work done, so big day ahead, and yeah, I'm going to take you guys along for the ride. See you soon. There it is, Great Amy Park. For those who don't know, we actually train across the road from Collingwood, so pretty cool. It's a big precinct, it's got Melbourne Rebels, Melbourne Victory, Melbourne Demons and us, so it's pretty cool to be surrounded by a whole heap of teams in the one precinct. Gym done, time for a little massage.
Justin. What are you singing, bro? Sweet Harold. Man, I just wanna go flex. Gold on my teeth and on my neck. And I'm stone cold with the flex. With my squad and I'm smoking up a check. Man, I just wanna go flex. Gold on my teeth and on my neck. And I'm stone cold with... You alright, bro? Any temperature? For the vlogs, mate, for the vlogs. What are you pretending to do, Chris? Is that a PowerPoint?
It is, mate.
That'll do me.
What's wrong with you?
You're making PowerPoints.
I'm sending a template for the big fella.
So you have to do Jonesy's templates, is that what you're saying?
I am, mate.
Interesting. Glad I got that on camera. Chris, you've recently taken up a new business venture at Stride.
Hey,
we're going to have you on the podcast in a couple of weeks.
Excited.
Why don't you give us a little bit of insight into it?
Oh, you wait and see you at the podcast, mate.
Yeah, thanks. It's not a compliment.
Haircut. Side profile, man.
Yeah, old
side profile. Yeah, that looks better. Yeah. Show us the back.
Yeah.
You know I'm going to cut Simple Jack into that.
As mad as Maxi Kings?
Nearly as bad as Max King's.
The magic happens. Hang on. I'm just going to put a little insert timeline for this graphic.
You said this
8 weeks.
This week.
Which side? Why?
So when
that's a good idea.
Can I do some behind the scenes?
Just because the camera's on, don't pretend you're the brains of the operation.
Hey guys, just about to record a new podcast with the great man, Justin Ollum. So really excited about this one. I know everyone's been pretty interested in his story of late, especially him getting a few games in the NRL, but the real in-depth story about his journey from PNG to the Melbourne Storm is a great one. So really excited about this and look forward to bringing it to you on Wednesday night. See
you. Yeah, just in the Storm office, bro.
Thank you.
Just finished a potty with Juzzy. He smashed it. So excited to bring that story to everyone. It's going to be so good. Just to hear like the actual details of you know, his journey through PNG. I don't think people truly understand what he went through. Just going to go home now, have a little snack, have a nap actually, day off, and then off to work. So I'll see you later. Snack time. Go to Giovanni. Not the plug. Good old Carmen's bars. Actually, question. Does anyone prefer the baby Chobani packs to the ones we have to use a spoon? Surely. I don't know why people even eat them anymore. That's all for the day.
Off to work.
I get so camera shy.
Hello, colleague.
Colleague?
Second floor.
Come, come. Yeah, see, footage like that isn't fun.
Yeah, it is for a little bit. Can't really get the license plate in.
Why don't you show the people our scooter?
This is our other mode of transport.
This bad boy.
But it's a little bit cold, so we're opting for the Yaris. Tonight, even if I've got three strikes, I'ma go for it. This moment, we own it. I'm not to be played with because it can get dangerous. Puffy.
Turn it off.
Did you do a podcast today?
Yeah, I had Justin Ollam on the podcast from The Storm. He's the guy that plays inside me, so you would...
Oh, he's the one that hugged you when you did your try?
Yes, so you would definitely recognise him. We played the Falcons together, so I've heard his story like a thousand times. Not like that, but me and him talking about it together, and he just always gives me these little bits every time, and I'm like, oh, if people could hear that, they'd be shocked, because like... Everyone understands, obviously, that the road from PNG to the NRL would be hard, but it's just all the little stories about, like, how he lives and that he wasn't even selected for any of the teams and just for him to get from the village to uni to play in the NRL, such a crazy story. And for him to actually be killing it now, like, that's unbelievable. The odds are, I don't know, millions to one, so this is so cool.
That's sick.
Yeah, so it was good to help him tell the story, hopefully.
Did he like talking about it?
Yeah, like, he's... He's proud of it and understands how rare it is for someone in his position to make it. Like, you know, he's super grateful. But yeah, he's stoked to tell his story, and if it can be inspiring at all for, he's pretty passionate about developing the pathways for young guys from PNG to make it to the NRL. He reckons there's guys in the villages that are like way better than him, just guns, but will never get an opportunity to make in the NRL because there's just no pathway out of like these remote places.
So what was his pathway then?
Well,
like, what's the difference between why he could and
not so much luck, but just the right opportunities. He focused on his education mostly for his whole life, driven by his mum, and he ended up going to uni. He's an engineer, like an electrical engineer.
Fuck, really?
Yeah, he did like a 4-year degree, so
God, that's sick. How old is he?
She used to be a member. he's like mid-20s. But, you know, we joke around that he's actually 45, but...
Old soul.
Looks 45.
Harsh.
He won't mind that. He doesn't have a birth certificate, so...
What?
It's always a running joke.
It's a good thing.
Yeah, he could be 50. Scenic route, but this is the way. That's all news, baby. This is today. They gon' miss us today. You will miss us today. This is the day. Took at the scenic route, but this is the way. That's all news, baby. This is today. They gon' miss us today. You will miss us today. Backyard blast, the dance till it's grass.
faceless patio glass, the Mazel Tov doctor's bomb, a bombastic. Used to drop acid, Marley comes soon, I only drop classics. Everyone asks when that heat gon' drop, when that knee gon' drop, when is he gon' pop? The question we all got, cause this could be our block. You're living in a glass house, we can see our clocks, but I can see it from the...
Alright, we're just going down to my pride and joy, F45 Little Collins, and we're going to do a session, 515 resistance, so let's go check it out. Alright guys, last task for the day, which is the storm hour on SEN. So me and Cooper John's just heading in now, so I'll take you through a little preview of the office. And we're locked out again. Classic.
Why are we FaceTiming?
You know the drill, mate. Open the door.
What are we doing here?
Don't ever make me wait again.
Hello, mate. How are you? Yeah. What's this for?
It's my camera, bro.
Nice.
The vlogging.
What are you vlogging?
Life.
What are you vlogging?
Life.
Life.
Yeah.
I don't have time to cook anything.
That'll do me.
What?
Diet of champions.
Well, no, I was going to cook a surf ride and I didn't have time.
Wow.
Still going. We're still cooking here.
Meals like this aren't going to do much for your Tinder profile, are they,
mate? I don't know if this is going on Tinder, to be honest.
This is going on Tinder, though.
What?
This sausage rig.
Yeah, I've got sausage arm.
This isn't actually your desk.
No, I just made it.
Yes. Only after hours.
Have I signed a waiver to be filmed against my consent?
Yeah, sue me.
Logging you or something?
Hey, man.
Yeah,
hey, guys.
And he called me at a really bad time.
What, did you have your hat off?
No, it wasn't that bad. I was having the world's most slovenly meal. I was cooking 3 sausages on a sandwich maker.
There you were.
Just to get something... Oh, we're back up. Just to get something back. Just happen something quickly.
And then I see you got a new hat, bro.
And then he starts... No, it's not new.
New Jets hat.
And then he starts pulling my shirt away, going, look at this.
I've actually got you this. Oh, it's a healthy snap.
What'd you get, mate?
Nothing, mate.
Nah.
You're back belting 3 sausages.
Yeah, it's a weird dessert, bro.
Macadamia and lemon.
Yeah, you let take what you get. Is that a fresh air car?
Nah.
Wow.
How did a week ago?
Kellick at the front, fade at the back.
Kellick there. Just to make it look good. Hey guys, I'm in for a really good show tonight. It's probably going to be the biggest one of the week, so
we only do one a week.
Yeah, no, it's going to be the biggest one of the week.
Speak for yourself, mate.
Yeah, well, right.
You're lucky to be on this show. We do multiple shows.
Seriously.
Yeah. Okay, we had a little
look out, mate. Hello, hello.
What's your phone on? Are we on now?
Sam McClure.
Is finished or?
Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah. We're out 55.
Oh, see, there's an ad break now.
Yeah, you've got a minute 40.
Probably not enough time. No,
you've got half your name on there, that's a good start.
Yeah, Sam.
Just turn Zeta on if you can.
That sort of looks like a ginger version of here.
Mayor's Loft, supplied by Top Cut Foods, Australia's specialist butcher.
Oh, headphones on.
Our city, your club.
It's not too late to join the Purple Army, get any two home games, a 2019 membership, a beanie, and access to all finals tickets for only $60. Melbourne Storm, our city, your club. Call 1300 786 767 or go to membership.melbournestorm.com.au. Sandor, Earl, Cooper, Johns.
Great intro, mate. Great intro.
And I've just got to say, it's very off-putting to turn around to say hello to you, and you've shoved a camera right within about half a metre of my face.
Yeah, it's your greatest fears come to life. You got on radio to escape this sort of stuff, and now we've been able to catch the visual. People are going to be very shocked.
The people of Twitter are going
to
be very shocked.
Have you ever done that? You know that first time you're listening to people on radio, and you're like, I'm going to Google to see what they look like.
And they look horrendous.
Wow.
Whoa.
Horrendous.
Not you're horrendous. Wow. I'm just saying in general.
Obviously, if we Googled you, nothing would come up. It would just come up Sandor and Cooper Johns.
Yeah. Oh, is that right?
It wouldn't come up with your face at all. It'd come up.
T-Bone of the Week nominations in. This is where we find out who you think's been the biggest idiot of the week in the world of rugby league. 1300 736 736. We'll talk Hall of Fame in just a moment. But boys, it was a big week for some of the team because they're big fans of the Aussie hip-hop legends, the Hilltop Hoods. They all went along to the concert, so we thought we'd get a concert review just to go behind the scenes of the day in the life of a rugby league player when they get some of the perks that you get to enjoy, and sometimes that's ticket to concerts. So Ryan Pappenhausen, who's been injured this year and about to come back into the side for the home game against the Raiders this week, has joined us on the line. Paps, how was the concert, mate?
Hey, boys.
Anyway, thanks, Paps, for that movie, the band review. Sandor, you've got some information about the comedy night coming up.
Yes, the comedy night on Sunday, August 18th. It's a player-driven event. It's going to be really good. Really, one of the genuine opportunities to mingle with players. We've got five of the best local comedians, the full NRL squad, and there'll be a series of auctions taking place throughout the afternoon, including signed jerseys and boots, some genuine one-off, one-of-a-kind items. So make sure you're there. You can book your tickets at thecomicslounge.com.au. It'll be Sunday afternoon, a great event. So if you're a Storm fan, something that definitely should not be missed.
That's awesome.
Yeah, it is. It sounds almost as good as that Hilltop Hoods concert. Yeah. That sounded fantastic.
I went too. It was outstanding.
It was? So tell us all about it.
Yeah, it was really good. Just like what Ryan said.
Yeah, you can't really top Ryan's review. I really felt like I was there.
Yeah. He doesn't write for Rolling Stone in his spare time, does he?
No, he doesn't.
He reads a lot of Time magazine, though.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Educated man.
Yeah, he's educated. So that was really good.
Good fun.
That's a wrap. Thanks, mate.
Thanks, mate. Oh, jeez. Good on you.
It's a sweaty hand.
No.
Oh, let's go. Alright guys, that's a wrap. That was my day off. Got plenty done. Going upstairs. Taco Tuesday. Bedtime. See you next time.